This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to show how to do some drug calculation problems when they involve converting between systems of measurement. So here's the first problem. This one says the order is for 60 milligrams. The medication on hand is 2 milligrams per milliliter. We want to find out how many tablespoons are to be given. So I'll start out by writing the order. That was 60 milligrams. And since I'm going to be dealing with fractions, I'll turn that into a fraction also. I'll put it over 1. On the right side of my equation, I want to leave a space for the answer, and then the unit that the answer has to be in. The answer has to be in tablespoons. Okay, now, I know that the medication on hand is 2 milligrams per milliliter. So I'm going to take my first fraction and multiply it by the fraction 1 milliliter over 2 milligrams. By putting milligrams in the denominator, I'll be able to cancel the milligrams out of both of these fractions. The answer has to be in tablespoons, so I'm going to need the conversion, the equivalence between tablespoons and milliliters. So I know there's 1 tablespoon for 15 milliliters, so I'll write a third fraction. That's going to be 1 tablespoon over 15 milliliters. By putting the tablespoon in the numerator, I'll end up with a tablespoon in my final answer. Okay, now let's see if we can cancel out all the units except for the tablespoons. So the milligrams will cancel. I've got milligrams in both the numerator and a denominator. The milliliters will cancel also. Then I've got 60 in the numerator and a 2 and a 15 in the denominator. I can simplify this before I multiply. So I can divide both the 60 and the 2 by 2. So 60 divided by 2 is 30, and 2 divided by 2 is 1. Now I've got 30 and 15, and I can divide both of those by 15. So 15 into 30 goes 2 times, and 15 divided by 15 is just 1. And now when I multiply across, I end up with, let's see, 2 times 1 times 1 tablespoon is just going to be 2 tablespoons. I don't have to worry about the denominators because they've all reduced to 1. Okay, let's try another one. This one says the order reads 300 milligrams. Available is 20 milligrams per teaspoon. How many milliliters are we to give? Okay, so let's start out with the order. That was 300 milligrams. I'll put that over 1. I want to end up with, let's see, milliliters. So I need to find out how many milliliters I'll need. I've got 20 milligrams per teaspoon. So let's multiply that first fraction by 1 teaspoon over 20 milligrams. And then we have to have a way of converting the teaspoons that we would have into milliliters. So let's see, the conversion for teaspoons to milliliters is 1 teaspoon equals 5 milliliters. We'll put the 5 milliliters in the numerator of a fraction, so we end up with milliliters. And we'll put the 1 teaspoon in the denominator. And then we'll cancel out whatever we can. So once again, we can cancel out milligrams. And we can cancel out the teaspoons. And we'll be left with just milliliters. That's what we want to end up with. Let's see if we can simplify this. I've got 320. So let's divide both of those numbers by 10. The 300 will become 30. The 20 will become just 2. And actually, I can divide the 30 and the 2, both of those by 2. So 30 divided by 2 is 15. And 2 divided by 2 is just 1. So I'm going to end up with 15 times 1 times 5, which is 75, and that's milliliters. Okay, so I've got 75 milliliters as my answer for this one. Let's do one more. This one involves grains. The order reads 1/10 grain. And available, we have 2 milligrams per milliliter. How many milliliters do we want to give? Okay, so the order is 1/10 grain. I'll make that whole thing into a numerator and put it over 1. I'm going to want to end up with milliliters, so I'll put that over on the right side. And then let's see what I'll have to do. I'm told that there's 2 milligrams per milliliter. Since I want to end up with milliliters, let's make a fraction with 1 milliliter in the numerator and 2 milligrams in the denominator. I put the 1 milliliter in the numerator so that I would end up with with milliliters as my units. We're dealing with grains, and we're going to have to convert between grains and milligrams. So the equivalence for that is 1 grain equals 60 milligrams. For my third fraction, I'll have 60 milligrams over 1 grain. Now, if I've done this right, I should be able to cancel out both the grains and the milligrams. So let's see. The grains are going to cancel. I've got grains in the numerator and the denominator. And the milligrams will cancel. I've got milligrams in both the numerator and the denominator. And now I've got 1/10 times 1 milliliter times 60. And I've got a 2 down here in the denominator. But let's multiply the 1/10 times the 60, because that will just be 6. So that would be 6 milliliters. The denominator is 1 times 2 times 1, so that's over 2. So we've got 6 over 2 milliliters, and we can reduce that. 6 divided by 2 is 3. So the answer is going to be 3 milliliters. Okay? So that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.